tower cam, somebody's digging a hole in 8th Street.
A small Indiana town was destroyed by a deadly tornado. Next, meet one woman who lived through the terrifying tornado. Next on Action 10 News, WTHI.
Destructive tornado in American history is the Tri-State Tornado. It was 80 years ago today. The tornado was on the ground for 3.5 hours, traveled 219 miles, had a mile-wide funnel, winds of more than 300 miles per hour, and killed 695 people. The reason it's called the Tri-State Tornado is because it began in Missouri, ran through all of southern Illinois, and then to Griffin, Indiana, which is where we go now, because I met a lady who has lived to tell us about what it was like in 1925. Griffin, a sleepy little town in southwestern Indiana, with 80 houses, a place to get some gas, and a population of about 160 friendly people. The Griffin, Indiana of 2005 is different than Griffin in 1925. That's because 80 years ago, Griffin was flattened, 100% destroyed, by the worst tornado in American history.
Probably maybe about 10 months.
Evelyn Stone was 7 years old on March 18, 1925, and remembers the day well.
It was balmy. It wasn't hot and it wasn't cold. Of course, this is March, you know. And the day seemed okay till about 4 o'clock, and then it began to cloud up.
With the gathering clouds came an ominous sound.
Yes, it was a big roaring. I remember that, yes. It roared, yes. Just like a train.
There was little time to react as the monster storm approached. Evelyn's mother scrambled to save her children.
And she hollered for my oldest sister to get the baby out of the window. And when she did, it blew right out.
The tornado came without warning, and nobody knew what to do.
Of course, the kids that was in the, left in the school, they weren't safe either. But they had a basement to go to, and they didn't know where to go to it, I don't guess.
This is all that is left of the old school, and a plaque nearby that names the 76 people killed in Griffin that day. The tornado had crossed the Wabash and was a 300-mile-per-hour whirling mass of mud and debris when it hit Griffin. The people who weren't killed were lost, including Evelyn's father.
And he was standing at the front door, and of course the front fell in on him, and that's when he got hurt. And we didn't know anything about it for 3 days later.
After the tornado, fires broke out, and the tragic events continued to unfold.
The grocery store owner's boy was there, and it caught a fire, and they couldn't get out. That they screamed and hollered and save me, save me. Nobody could get to them, so they died.
Survivors were taken to makeshift shelters, and the reality of the event began to unfold.
I just didn't think it'd ever be the same. But to me, it just, well, it looked disastrous. That's all there was to it.
Today, Griffin has mostly rebuilt. And while this remains the greatest tornado disaster in American history, time has allowed for some embellishments.
I heard one person say that they seen a mule flying through the air with the 2x4 through it. Now, believe it or not.
Evelyn Stone survived the worst tornado ever. But not all scars are physical.
And every time they would come on the radio or television talking about a tornado headed our way, I'd break out in hives.
Evelyn Stone is one of only three people alive today in Griffin who can tell us what it was like to live through the great Tri-State Tornado of 1925. Evelyn Stone, a true survivor.